बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। क्लास 9 स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिक्स, चैप्टर नंबर 3। द नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज डायनामिक्स। नाउ व्हाट इज डायनामिक्स? टू अंडरस्टैंड द नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम फिजिक्स, वी नो दैट फिजिक्स हैज़ मैनी ब्रांचेस। वन ऑफ द ब्रांचेस is mechanics. You have studied about different branches in chapter number 1. So one of the branches is mechanics, and further mechanics is divided into two different branches, which is known as sub branches. One is kinematics, one is dynamics. Kinematics means we study the motion of different bodies, different types of motions, but without considering different causes. I have discussed this topic of kinematics in the starting of chapter number 2. You can watch that video again. So hopefully you can easily understand what is kinematics, because we have discussed already. Okay? Now this time we have to understand this chapter number 3, main sub branch of mechanics, which is known as dynamics. What is dynamics? Dynamics basically the study of motion along with causes. So it means now in this chapter we will study about all those different things which are basically directly or indirectly they are affecting the motion. So when we study the motion of object along with the causes, then it means we are studying dynamics. The scope of dynamics is larger than kinematics. Okay, so if we say what are different causes, I have already studied about different causes in the starting of chapter, first lecture of chapter number 2. You can watch there again. So if I discuss about causes, so causes are like force, friction, mass, weight, etc. Basically, if something is moving and if you apply the force from opposite direction, so it means you will be able to stop, or if you want to decrease the motion of the object, so you can apply the force from opposite direction. Similarly, if there is some friction existing between the two surfaces, so it means now that friction will oppose the motion. Motion will be affected by friction. If you reduce the friction, definitely the motion of the object will be greater. Mass, if you increase the mass of an object, definitely there will be effect on the motion. For example, if you are pulling a trolley and if trolley is empty, then you can easily move the trolley with some particular motion and velocity and speed. But if you are filling up that trolley with different objects, so as you increase the mass, you will feel that there will be a difficulty for pulling that cart in a particular direction, because velocity or speed of that trolley will be affected by the help of increasing mass. Same like weight. If you are increasing the weight, if you increase the mass, so it means you are increasing the weight, and when you are increasing the weight, definitely motion will be affected. So basically the difference between mass and weight we will study later on, but here in the same chapter, chapter number 3, we will discuss. But here just only I am giving you these are the causes which are affecting the motion of that object. Along with the motion we will discuss these causes as well. That's why we are starting our chapter from the first topic, which is force. Okay, so what is force? Force is basically a physical quantity that moves or tends to move an object. Means if you are applying force on an object, maybe you will be able to move that object. But sometime you are applying the force of an object and you are unable to move, but even then you have tried to move that object. You have tend to move that object. So force can move or tends to move. Similarly, force can stop or tends to stop. Tends to stop means try to stop. But even if body is if you are unable to stop that body, but you have applied force, so we can say that you have applied force, but because of your force, since body is having larger mass, you are unable to stop that moving body, but even then you have applied some force. So it means your force can stop or tends to stop the motion of an object. Is it? Similarly, force can also change the direction. If something is lying, for example, if this pen is lying and pen is moving in this direction, and if I apply force, I can change the direction of this. By applying force, I can change the direction of this ballpoint or moving object. Is it clear? Similarly, motion can change the shape of an object. Let's suppose if I bend this by applying force, I can change the shape of this object. I can change the size of this object. I can increase the size of object. Okay, I can increase the area of an object. I can increase the volume of object by applying force. So in ordinary life, you have a lot of examples in which you apply force and you can change the area. Is it? You can increase the area, you can increase the length. If you are pulling a rubber, so it means you are increasing the length of that rubber band. It means you can increase the length, you can increase the area. Is it? Similarly, you can increase the volume of an object by increasing its length and width and height. Is it clear? So it means now force is physical quantity which can do all these things that I have discussed. Okay, so wait for the next video.